Good morning, Unity on the Bay.
Good morning, Faye.
I feel you and I see you, and we're just so blessed to be together this morning. My name is Faye Tatiana Carmona Albernas, and it is truly an honor and a pleasure to be with you this morning, assisting Reverend Chris. I got a couple of things to let you guys know about this morning. So a few years ago, we brought back a very popular prosperity program called Unexpected Income, and since that time, participants have realized over $200,000 in extra income. So this year, we're bringing it back again, but you're late. It started on May 4th, but we're gonna keep registration open until today. So head on over to the website and get registered. There is an unexpected income waiting for you, unityonthebay.org. Next. Our next new member orientation is coming up on Sunday, May 17th at 1 p.m. online. This is your chance to commit to your own spiritual growth and through the power of community, the spiritual growth of hundreds of others. Being a member is an important and valued step in this community, and only members can vote at membership meetings. We only have 3 orientations per year, so please take advantage of this one. You must register online, unityonthebay.org. Look for the new member orientation tab. Look, I'm Oprah. And lastly, what is life asking of us right now? We have an unprecedented opportunity to create profound changes in our lives and in our world. Each of us is invited to let go of conditioned ideas of how our life should be and discover a new story, a soul-level story, that allows us to live a life that feels more aligned, more fulfilling, and contributes more fully to our world. On May 19th, get inspired into action in your life and for our world by joining Val Siliker, co-founder and director of the Psycho Spiritual Institute, for a special 4-part workshop called Deep Resilience, Transforming Crisis into Empowerment. Now please welcome our Reverend, Reverend Chris Jackson.
Good morning, Unity on the Bay. Welcome to your positive path for spiritual living. And aren't you, dear friend, grateful that you have discovered a positive path for spiritual living, one that can move you and guide you and gently inspire you through whatever the world of time and space may bring your way. I want to give you the assurance that we are practicing social distancing in the room this morning as we bring this broadcast to you, and we're grateful for your safety as well as for our own. If this is your first or second Unity on the Bay experience with us right now, we invite you to stay tuned to the comments below. There's going to be an opportunity there for us to get to know you better and for you to get to know a little bit more about the spiritual community that is Unity on the Bay. While we're continuing to enjoy this wonderful facility we've been blessed with at Temple Israel, we also want to keep our minds and our hearts focused on the direction of our future and the new home that ultimately Unity on the Bay will enjoy. I remind you that you, dear friend, have the power of the spoken word. There's an energy and a vibration in every word that rolls across your lips. Let's remember this as we consciously and intentionally affirm together the Building Our Future affirmation for Unity on the Bay. We give thanks that Unity on the Bay's right and perfect home is manifesting under the guidance of God. Here at Unity on the Bay, we enjoy a series of core values that constitute the foundation of everything we do and all that we are. I invite you to continue exercising the power of your spoken word as we affirm these values together. Diversity, generosity, gratitude, integrity, love, spirit-led, and wisdom. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers who may be viewing at this time. If you are a mother, a grandmother, a great-grandmother, a great-great-grandmother, we want to give you our love and our appreciation in this time we share together this morning. I have right here behind me this beautiful candle that is a symbol of all those mothers that we have appreciated, loved, and admired that are no longer with us, my own being one of them. So as we move through this service today, I invite you to remember those individuals who have played the role of motherhood in your life and the lives of those you love and have now moved on to other dimensions of their eternal life, as together we hold them in our hearts and in our prayers. Let's take a moment now to close our eyes, if that's possible for you in this moment right now, and bring to mind the true spirit of every human being. There is in every one of us a divine masculine and a divine feminine. Anytime we find ourselves in peril or trial or tribulation, it is always the universe extending an opportunity to us to express more fully the completeness of who we are. You and I, we're made in the image and the likeness of God. The image and the likeness of all that is sacred and holy and pure and beautiful and whole. So this morning, as we are acknowledging the motherhood of all humanity and all of life, we acknowledge it first and foremost within ourselves. We give thanks that we have been created of wholeness, and that that wholeness is available to serve and guide and support us in this day and all of our days. Dear God, we are grateful for the feminine spirit that indwells every human heart and its ability to guide us with strength, calm, nurturing presence, and love today and always. This we pray in the name, in the nature, and through the power of the Christ presence that we are. Thank you, God. Amen.
Good morning. Though I may speak with bravest fire and have the gift to all inspire, and have not love, my words are vain as clashing brass and hopeless gain. Oh, I may give all I possess, and striving so my love profess, but not begin my love with you. The prophet soon turns strangely thin. Come, Spirit, come. Our hearts enfold, our spirits long to be made whole. Let inward love guide every deed. By this we worship and are free. Let inward love guide every deed. By this we worship and are free.
Simply beautiful. Thank you so much, Dale. Thank you so much, Anthony. And I'm loving the tie, Dale, loving the tie. It is now time for our daily word. And our daily word today is going to be read by our own board president, Eddie Dominguez, from the comfort of his beautiful home via Zoom. Eddie?
Good morning and happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. I'm coming to you from my home in the Little Havana neighborhood of Miami. And I've been here for about a month now with little to no interaction with the outside world, except through video, WebEx, Zoom, and the many fortunate digital ways in which we're able to continue connecting. because were it not for that, this would definitely be an incredibly lonely and disconnected time. So I thank God for the technology that we have that is allowing us to stay connected and stay together at a time when, frankly, I think we all really need it. I want to start by telling you a little bit about what's been going on behind the scenes. Continuity has been something that has been at the top of the priority list for your board of trustees, and continuity from a business perspective, but most importantly, from a service perspective, meaning that once we made the decision to close in-person services, how were we going to be there? How were we going to show up for you at the time when you needed us most? I think our staff has answered that question and answered it incredibly well. I'm very grateful to our ministers and to our staff team for helping us show up for you in many new and innovative ways. So thank you to Reverend Chris, to Reverend Juan, to Jason, to Dale, to Anthony, to Faye, and everyone working behind the scenes to make this possible. From our morning meditations and prayers to our ongoing video services for the Wednesday Om Hour and our Sunday services. We also have built on our already robust digital offering with new classes and really timely classes that are designed to help us get through this time period. The other thing that has been a top priority for us is financial management and making sure that we're able to be resilient at this time. Fortunately, we're in a much different financial position today than we were just 2 years ago. So we do have a lot of buffer room, so to speak, but we're still taking a big hit financially. And I ask you to continue supporting us if you can at this time, because the main revenue generator for Unity on the Bay still is our Wednesday and especially our Sunday services. So again, if you can continue showing up for us and supporting us financially, please do so. And if not, it's okay. The other thing that we wanted to make sure is that we were there to support our congregation, and we are doing that, not just spiritually, but also in certain very specific ways financially. The board has also made a decision that we are going to continue paying all staff and contractors at least through May 15th. Even though we're not holding services and most of our contractors are engaged in doing these services, the board really decided that this was our opportunity to step up, and we knew that the entire community would be supportive of this. So we made the decision to continue paying our contract staff through May 15th, give them the time that they needed to get government support and other support that has been created for those purposes. So thank you to the board for that generosity. Thank you to each and every one of you for continuing to show up for Unity on the Bay. And now for the daily word, which appropriately is Mother's Blessing. I honor all mothers and am grateful for their love. I bless my mother and am grateful to her for the gift of nurturing love. Whether my mother is still with me or has passed on, her love still lives in my heart and her wisdom continues to inspire me. I am grateful for the many ways in which my mother has blessed me. I also feel deep appreciation and tender affection for all those who have blessed me with the selfless gift of motherly love. I would not be who I am without them. Through the living example of mothers in my life, I pass along the blessings of a mother's care and devotion as I embrace opportunities to share an affirming thought, an encouraging word, a smile, or a simple act of kindness. I honor my mother and all mothers as I share the love of God that never fails. This is inspired by Proverbs 31, verse 26. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. Thank you very much for joining us today, and thank you very much for being a part of the Unity on the Bay community. At this time, we really need these principles and these teachings. I, for one, am leaning on them very heavily, and I hope that we have been there for you at this time of critical need on so many levels. So again, if we can be there for you in any way, please reach out. Unity on the Bay is here for you today, will be here for you tomorrow and always. Thank you very much. I love you all, and I am so looking forward to when we can join back together again for services in person. I have been joking that I am planning a Unity on the Bay group hug in the parking lot. And while that's been a joke, look for it, because we're going to do a group hug. Again, I love you all. Have a great Sunday.
Thank you, Eddie. At this time, as we prepare for a time of guided meditation led by Chris, I want to remind you that if you have any prayer intentions that you'd like to submit, you can do so in the comments section or on our website at unityonthebay.org/prayer. Our prayer chaplains will be answering your prayer intentions either way. So now let us ease into a time of meditation with this song by Dale and Anthony. We'll put the lyrics up on the screen so you can read along.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be, let it be. Let it be, let it be, oh, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. And when the night is cloudy, there is still a light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be. Wake up to the sound of music, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be, oh, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be, let it be. Let it be, let it be, oh, let it be. There will be an answer, let it be.
I invite you to close your eyes if that's possible for you in this moment. Let it be an outward gesture of your willingness to release all preoccupation with the things of the world you perceive outside of yourself. And remember, recognize, and celebrate the world that is within you. In this moment, yes, but always and forever. A presence of power, a truth of your nature as made by God, that is in this and every moment extending to you an invitation to come ye apart a while into the full realization of the truth of your being. Dear friend, you are a whole person, a whole person. As a whole person, created in the image and the likeness and the fullness and the richness of God's presence, you are capable of expressing in infinite myriad ways this truth of your identity. Within every one of us, there is a mothering spirit. We give thanks for the manner in which we have seen that spirit reflected in the eyes, in the smiles, in the touches of those who have served in the role of mother in our lives. And we also recognize that same grand motherly tenderness is contained as an aspect within the fullness of our being on Mother's Day and every day of our eternal lives. There is a space of consciousness within every one of us that is embracing, that is comforting, that is nurturing, and that is loving all of who we are in this moment and all of what we perceive in others and in life. This is your own divine feminine nature, and it is required of the expression of your wholeness that you are able to live in that divine nature fully, completely, comfortably, and confidently accept the wholeness. Celebrate the fullness of all that you are. And let it be a living testimony in your life every moment of your own remembrance and your own willingness to give full consent to every aspect of your being, every divine attribute contained within you, to shine brightly in a world that needs all of you, that desires all of you, that in fact longs for all of you. Be willing to step beyond the labels and prescriptions and concepts that the world around you has placed upon you, and celebrate that you are much more than anything anyone has ever described you to be. You're much more than anything you have ever defined yourself to be or thought yourself to be. You're beyond description. You're beyond phenomenal. You're beyond magnificent. You are an individualized and totally unique expression of God. And as you accept this realization for yourself, you're able to begin to accept it for all others. Everybody on the face of this planet is living to be whole, is living to be a demonstration of the fullness of everything that life is capable of becoming in each of our experiences. Take this recognition and this awareness into the silence and the stillness of your own being, and just rest with the wholeness, the totality, the fullness, the greatness, and the grandeur that you are. Let this be your moment. Let this be your moment to shine. Let this be your moment in which you recognize that there is nothing beyond your capacity or your capability to be, to do, to live, and to love in this world. And celebrate that you're everything God is made of. Now, always, and forever. This we pray in the name and in the nature and through the power of everything that is sacred and everything that is holy. And that, dear friend, is everything. Thank you, God. Amen.
What do you give to the lady who has given all her life and love to you? What do you give to the reason you are living? I could window shop the world before I'm through. eyes, Mama, the moon to wear. That's not good enough, no, not good enough, not for Mama. Mama, a palace, diamonds like doorknobs, mountains of gold to spare. That's not rich enough, no, not rich enough, not for Mama. Mama, lifetime crowded with laughter, that's not long enough, not half long enough. Mama, a palace, diamonds like doorknobs, mountains of gold to spare. That's not rich enough, no, not rich enough, not for Mama. Mama, a lifetime crowded with laughter, that's not long enough, not half long enough. What can I give you that I can give you? What will your present be? Mama, loved and beautiful, always loved and beautiful. That's the Mama I'll always see.
We are so blessed to have this gentleman, both of these gentlemen, with us throughout these broadcasts we've been bringing you. The first time I heard Dale sing that song was just a few moments before I had to get up and speak, and I was so emotionally drained by it that I could hardly get a word out of my mouth. This morning I thought, well, I'll be better because I know the song now, and I know it's going to touch my heart, which in fact it did. I don't know that I handled it any better, but here I am. Happy Mother's Day, everybody. I want to share with you some words today from the co-founder of the Worldwide Unity Movement. Her name was Myrtle Fillmore, and she was frequently and affectionately referred to as Mama Myrtle, or the Mother of Unity. Heretofore, we may not have seen much in life in this world that was particularly pleasing or worthwhile. Such a meager outlook results from our trying to see life through a little knothole of personality. We have received the messages that our parents, our teachers, our superior officers, and the world in general have given us through our senses. Thus, we have formed biased opinions of the things within us and about us. We have seen what appears because of limited information and not what God has created. God has made me to know that no matter what I have done or what others have done to me, He has implanted within me a pattern of perfection. He has given me the life, power, intelligence, and substance out of which I may recreate my soul qualities and my physical structures, and so come forth a new creature. It's astounding to me that so many years ago, in the mid-1800s, this woman was already beginning to understand very current and contemporary spiritual principles dawning in the collective consciousness of humanity in such a way that I believe with all my heart she was actually able to redefine what it meant to be a woman, what it meant to be a mother, what it meant to be a wife, and what it meant to be a challenging pioneer of spirit who questioned in no small way all of the religious thinking of her time. And she took her husband with her. Today, Unity is still predominantly led by women. And I am proud of this, that we have always recognized the importance of the role of the masculine and the feminine, the man and the woman. And we have realized that masculinity and femininity are not confined to sexuality or to gender. We all have a masculine nature and a feminine nature that dwells within us. Myrtle was profoundly ahead of her time and beautifully feminine. She was one of the most sensitive people, as commented on by all those who knew her. She was nurturing, she was kind, and yet she was also distinctly masculine. She was powerful, she was bold, she was rebellious. And I really believe that in these times through which we are traversing presently, there is a great call to see a finer example of what it means to be a sensitive man and what it means to be a very powerful woman. Let me share with you a story, pieces and parts of this story you've heard me share before, but it's the story of the woman who made it possible for us to be under the banner of what we call the Worldwide Unity Movement today. She was born as Mary Caroline Page on August 6, 1945, 1845, in Pagetown, Ohio. The town was actually named after her family. She passed on as Myrtle Fillmore on October 6, 1931, at the age of 86 at Unity Village, Missouri, the location of our world headquarters. Her passing was 45 years after she had received a terminal diagnosis of tuberculosis. Myrtle was raised by Marcus and Lucy Page. They were both devout Methodists, and while the Methodist influence was strong in Myrtle's family, when she was actually asked as a relatively young lady whether or not she wanted to join the church, she said, "I do not believe in hell, and I won't belong to a church that practices it." And can you catch what I'm talking about when I say she was rebellious? She was defiant. She knew her own mind and heart and had a level of courage even at a young age to follow it. She was intelligent. She was independent, extremely strong-minded, and yet, in the same breath, she could be absolutely comforting, beautifully gentle, and unconditionally loving. Myrtle met Charles Fillmore, her soon-to-be husband, at a literary club meeting in Denison, Texas, and they were married on March 29, 1881. Myrtle reflects on what I now consider to be the Fillmore family philosophy, having been privileged and honored and grateful to have worked with three generations of the Fillmore family. I can tell you that these words that Myrtle spoke are true of every succeeding generation that led the Unity Movement for many years to follow. She says, "We have never cared to interest folks in our own lives. It makes no difference to others what we have done, who we are. What is important is that we are doing what God has given us to do according to our best light." And the reason I love these words so much is because both the Fillmores recognized that the attention that they began to receive as they grew into a worldwide stature of recognition as the founders of the Unity Movement was never preoccupying their mind. They weren't concerned about exalting themselves. They never espoused the idea that they had come across something that was exclusively theirs by divine right. They knew that what they had been given was a gift from God, and that in all humility, they were here to be servants of that. On the evening of their wedding, they left for Gunnison, Colorado, to profit in a real estate boom that was happening in the state of Colorado. They had to cross the Continental Divide. Now, you have to first of all understand that Myrtle had been raised as a relatively frail child, And her father had contracted tuberculosis. She believed that that was an hereditary situation that in all likelihood she would wind up suffering from herself. And yet here's this little feisty lady deciding she's going to cross over the continental divide partially by stagecoach and partially on a horse-drawn sleigh across the mountains of the divide. Again, we see here the interesting, contrasting, and yet complementing qualities of her determination, her courage, her defiant nature, along with a certain humility and soft-heartedness and reassuring that actually was quite puzzling to the gentleman who had accompanied her on this trek across the continental divide. All of them were astounded that she was able to hold up as well as she did, and we were able to see what was really a pioneering spirit in this woman that would evolve to even greater and greater levels. In 1884, the Fillmores left Colorado and decided to move to Kansas City, primarily because the real estate activity had sort of moved in that direction, and this was Charles's profession. He thought this would be his golden opportunity for prosperity. And yet it was during that particular period of time that he also received a dream. And in that dream, he was told to remain in Kansas City, that he had a great work to do, and that this would be the location from which it would be accomplished. From that rather promising dream one evening, the Fillmores moved into the greatest peril probably of their life together, and that was specifically in 1886, Myrtle's diagnosis of tuberculosis, through which she was given a very short time to live. Myrtle sought many different remedies for her ailment, including all the medical solutions that were available, to no avail. And so she began looking at alternative methods of healing, arriving at a lecture one evening in April of 1886 that was delivered by a gentleman named Dr. E.B. Weeks. This guy was what they called a metaphysician, and Myrtle was fascinated by the lecture and the words that Dr. Weeks was speaking. Specifically, one statement, you've heard this before, but it really bears repeating, and it's really worthwhile to consider whether or not you really believe the words that Dr. Weeks spoke that evening when he said, "I am a child of God, and therefore I do not inherit sickness." Now, while these words flew in the face of all the conditioning Myrtle had ever received, there was something inside of her that took them in and believed them. I think it was a remembrance of her spiritual reality and the truth she was a child of God. But I ask you this morning, do you believe those words? Do you really believe? I know they sound lovely, but do you really believe that you are God's perfect child? And as such, it is not possible for you to inherit sickness. Through this belief, Myrtle experienced a complete healing of her physical body. Within 2 years, she was completely whole and well and quite active for decades to follow in not only beginning, but also fostering the growth of the Worldwide Unity Movement. As we reflect on Myrtle's healing and the subsequent founding of the Unity Movement, it's important, I think, to realize that the Fillmores were never about promoting themselves again. They were not even particularly about promoting unity. They were just trying to accept an assignment that they had been given. Myrtle said, "Now, where did you get the idea that you should follow unity? Where did you get the idea that you should follow unity or that you should follow the Fillmores?" She says, "Our prayers and our lectures and our literature are to point the individual to the source of his life and every good within his own spiritual consciousness." And I want to remind you of this today on this beautiful Mother's Day. The whole concept of what we do here at Unity on the Bay is not designed to get you to convert your belief system into something other than it already is. Our purpose is to draw you within to the center of your being, wherein you are able to remember your personal and unique understanding of your relationship with God, and then create your own religion, create your own movement, create your own way of being and your own lifestyle that is born out of the integrity of everything that makes up who you are. Myrtle Fillmore believed wholeheartedly in the power of prayer, and so do we. We believe that it's impossible, that it is possible for you to have a direct connection with the divinity that indwells you and that prayer is your ticket into this particular situation, this particular experience. Out of this was birthed through Myrtle Fillmore what originally was called the Society of Silent Help and is now known across the planet as Silent Unity, our 24-hour, 7-day-a-week prayer ministry that continues to serve millions of people, most of whom will never experience the personal nature of a spiritual community in unity, but are nonetheless blessed by the work that Myrtle did. Myrtle embraced what I consider to be all of the divine feminine and all of the divine masculine. She knew that she was made in the image and likeness of God, and she knew that image and likeness was capable of containing all expression through human form. She said, though personal to each of us, God is it, neither male nor female, but principle. God is not a cold, senseless principle like that of mathematics, but the principle of life and love and intelligence. So she caught this universality that makes up the presence of God, of which we are all a unique expression. Thus, we are all whole persons, and each of us is capable of embodying all aspects of character. As I was assembling the words I wanted to share with you this morning, I did a little research, because I've always felt that in some ways the world suffered a little bit as we as individualized human beings sought to fit into the molds that have been created for us by social conditioning. I believe that there is a wholeness about us that can express in both masculine and feminine ways, and oftentimes we may find ourselves in an attempt to strive for social conformity, dampening one or the other within us, either our masculine nature or our feminine nature. And I came across the work of a writer named Tamsin Firestone. This is in her book called Daring to Love. She says, "It is harmful to think of yourself in terms of being masculine and feminine. Research indicates that these are arbitrary and artificial distinctions. We all have traits that would be considered masculine and feminine, and we all know men who are nurturing and sensitive to children, and women who are ambitious and aggressive in business. Any stereotypic views of what it means to be a man or a woman are limiting and hurtful to the individual." Those are powerful words, my friends, limiting and hurtful. Whenever we take on a stereotypical viewpoint of what we think we need to be, one of the things I applaud and appreciate the most about the movement of which you are a part is our ability to accept all people in the manner in which they have been guided to demonstrate who they are in the world. And anything less than that prevents the wholeness of humanity from coming into expression. We each embody the Father God and the Mother God. And we can be daring enough, courageous enough, just as Myrtle Fillmore was through all those years of her life, to demonstrate both. We're in a place right now, my friends, where it is imperative, I believe, that a man master the art of shedding a tear, of being touched emotionally at the center of their being, and that women find the strength to stand up and speak their mind with confidence in who they are, unobscured by any social label that wants to keep anybody in a certain place at a certain time. There is before us right now the power for all of us to rise up as whole people, expressing as we are guided in every moment and allowing the fullness of who we are to bring forth the fullness of the experience that we are capable of sharing with ourselves and with others. I close this morning by sharing the words of a beautiful poem written by Myrtle Fillmore in 1897. "I do not believe in evil. I believe in good. I do not believe in sin. I believe in truth. I do not believe in want. I believe in abundance. I do not believe in death. I believe in life. I do not believe in ignorance. I believe in intelligence. There are no discords in my being. Being is at peace. My faith, my understanding, and my love are becoming one. What God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. My dear friend, what God has joined together in you is a full and creative spirit. And this Mother's Day could be your opportunity to celebrate your mother's life, your grandmother's life, or the mother of anyone at any time, anybody that has served in the role of mother in your own experience. Recognize that the greatest legacy you can leave them is to defy any construct around you that seeks to put a damper on who you are. With that, I say, happy Mother's Day to the mother, the spirit of motherhood that lives in each and every one of us. And let us move forward in the continuing journey of faith that was launched by the brilliance of Myrtle Fillmore, the mother of unity. God bless you. Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you so much, Reverend Chris. What a powerful message. And I love all the writings of Myrtle Fillmore. So powerful, so powerful. So we're so blessed to belong to the spiritual community, Unity on the Bay, and to be spiritually fed every Sunday. We especially appreciate you during these challenging times. Our Sunday celebrations and Om Hour are the primary ways in which we are financially supported. And we are continuing to be mindful and serve as good stewards of all we have and all we receive while we provide the necessary programming to support you, our spiritual community. Your giving is made simple through text giving or through our website. If you want to go via text, just text UOTB to 73256. That's UOTB to 73256. You can set that up one time, and then it's just a couple clicks to do it every Sunday. Or you can visit unityonthebay.org, and we'll put all that information up on the screens for you. We thank you for your gifts this morning, and let's bless these gifts together. Hold your phone to your heart or however you want to do it. Divine love that I am blesses all that I give and all that I receive. Now it is time to bring the kiddies up to the screen. Bring the kids up to the screen. Bring them up. Not too close, not too close. You can also bring your four-legged friends. I usually do that as well. And let's bless these children, these amazing children. Let's get our hands ready. Children, we love you. We bless you. We appreciate you. We behold the Christ in you, and we see you doing great things. This broadcast is being aired on Sunday, May 10th. Happy Mother's Day. If you're watching us for the first or second time, we'd love to get to know you better. Just text NEW, N-E-W, to 305-573-9191. That's NEW to 305-573-9191, and we'll send you a gift and more information about Unity on the Bay. If you'd like us to pray with you, we'll put a link in the comments section with more information on how you can submit a prayer intention. Now, join us as Dale leads us in a prayer for protection.
The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is and all is well. Thank you so much for being with us today. Now join along as we sing together the peace song. Have a great day.